Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Hope you guys are doing all right. I want to make a couple of videos tonight. First of all, I'm wearing my Rapture t-shirt. Those of you who have been following my videos for a long time, you know what I'm talking about. Way back. Oh, if you don't know Grasshopper, you'll have to go look at my old videos. Look for the videos of me wearing this t-shirt. Praise God, brothers and sisters, because the Lord confirmed again to me tonight and spoke to me that the rapture is pre-tribulation. That's why I want to title this video. Now, I just want to say this, that I made several videos talking about the pre-tribulation rapture and the Bible verses to support it and all that. And I will say this. When you listen to people who make arguments that the rapture is post-trib or whatever, there is no rapture, their arguments is all emotions and human logic, and not the Word of God. Not the Word of God. One Bible verse that you'll hear people quote is they'll say, like they have a documentary made by Alex Jones. Alex Jones is a nominal Christian who doesn't believe in the rapture. And they made a video called After the Tribulation, and they quote the Bible verse where Jesus says, you know, immediately after the tribulation. It says, the Lord will gather His elect from the four corners of heaven. He'll gather all people that belong to God in one place. There's people that died thousands of years ago, the Old Testament saints. After Jesus' crucifixion and death, He descended, the Bible says, into hell, into Sheol, it's called, into the paradise, into the bosom of Abraham, and He led captivity captive, the Bible tells us. He preached the gospel to the Old Testament saints, to those people who were in paradise because of their righteousness as Old Testament righteous saints. But they weren't saved because nobody could get saved until Jesus shed His blood. They heard the gospel, they got saved, and then the Lord led them, and then they were the first people to enter heaven. As they say, before the death of Christ, the resurrection of Christ and His death, there were no people in heaven. No one could enter into God's presence without their sins being removed. That's what the blood of Jesus is all about, to remove our sins. And in the Old Testament, under the law of Moses, they did sacrifices that covered their sins but did not remove them. In the book of Hebrews, it tells us that when Jesus was crucified and His blood was shed, all of those bloods, blood that was shed of the bulls and goats was counted as the blood of Christ. And the blood of Christ removed the sins of those Old Testament people. After His death, God grandfathered in all of their sacrifices under the blood of Christ after the death of Christ. And then those people were able to enter into the heaven. And then everyone who became a follower of Jesus after that day are part of the church. Until today, are part of the church of Christ, all who became born again. So there's their Old Testament saints, and then there's the church, and then there's the tribulation saints. Now, brothers and sisters, when you begin to study the Word of God and go by Bible verses, when we look at the pre-tribulation rapture, there are dozens of Bible verses to back up and support this idea of the pre-tribulation rapture, to be caught up, the Bible says, to be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. Lots of people who are not saved, they're lukewarm, are unsaved, backsliders, who take comfort in thinking that they, you know, because they're living in sin, it's not going to be a penalty for that. So therefore, as Paul says, wherefore, in King James or in English, therefore comfort one another with these words. These backsliders, these wicked tares, these people who think they're going to, you know, get saved at the last minute during the tribulation, these are the ones who are comforting one another with the words that there is no reward for being part of the faithful, diligent bride of Christ. And there is a reward. There is a reward for those who diligently seek the Lord, Hebrews chapter 11. The Lord is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. It says it's our blessed hope. It is the blessed hope, and God has a special crown for those who love His appearing. Hallelujah. The Lord has got a special crown for us. So tonight, the two times the Lord has spoken to me that the pre-tribulation rapture was real, even though there's tons of Bible verses. The Lord didn't have to speak that to me to know what the Bible says. It's not emotions. Oh, the church needs to be purified. If the church needs to be purified, then the blood of Christ is of none effect. And all the people that died before the tribulation started must be in hell because they didn't have a chance to be purified through the rapture, through the tribulation. So therefore, wherefore, discourage one another with these words that if you're not right with God, you're not going into rapture. But if you are right with God, you are going in the rapture. Okay, to be kind of worthy to escape these things, as Jesus said. There's dozens of Bible verses. These people that don't know the Word of God, that are just copying and pasting off of YouTube, they'll say, there's no word rapture in the Bible. Easiest one in the world. If you're a Christian, you should know how to answer, to give an account for the hope that lies within you, to give a defense, as Peter said, of the hope that lies within you. The word rapture is just merely the Latin word for being snatched up, to be caught up. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, and 18. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them to meet the Lord in the air. Therefore shall we forever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Anyway, brothers and sisters, way back, several years ago, lots of the pastors I know who I respected, turns out that they were, not all of them, most of them were living in sin. As a matter of fact, one turned out to be a big-time homosexual who's a pastor of one of the largest churches in the Philippines. But I had respected them and didn't know all that at the time. And many pastors who are still in the ministry, they stopped believing in the rapture. And their logic was, the church needs to be purified. The Bible doesn't talk about that. That's not what the Bible says. The Bible says we're not appointed under wrath. And God's wrath, the tribulation, all the tribulation is God's wrath. It's God's judgment and punishment on earth for rejecting the Messiah. What anything the devil does is under the authority and allowed by God. The God uses the devil to bring his wrath. And the Antichrist. It's God is allowing that to go forward, to bring his judgment and wrath on people. People want the devil to rule over them? Okay, here you go. Here he is. Jesus said, I come, you know, and you don't accept me, but there's one who's coming in his own name, and him you will accept. He's talking about the Antichrist. So several years ago, I was praying about it because these preachers were telling me there's no, you know, it's no pre-tribulation rapture. Stop believing in it. You know? And that, to me, that's a sign of the end times. They're rejecting the Word of God and just going with their some of their wacky ideas. It's not biblically based. So I prayed about it, and the Lord spoke to me and says, the Lord asked me, what does my word say? I said, well, Lord, what? I don't know. You tell me, Lord, what does your word say? And the Lord gave me these two Bible verses, and he said that when Jesus and Matthew went to Caesarea Philippi, there's a place there called the Gates of Hell, and there used to be a waterfall coming out of this place through this tunnel, this cave. It was called the Gates of Hell, but there was an earthquake after the time of Jesus, just after the time of Jesus, or sometime. I'm trying to remember the date now, but anyway, after the life of Christ, there was an earthquake there. I started to say just after the death of Christ, but I think it was in 1800s or 1900s. There was an earthquake there that destroyed that gate, and the water stopped coming through there anymore. But that place there in Caesarea Philippi was known as the Gates of Hell. And Jesus was in front of that when he said, you know, he asked them, who do you say that I am? Matthew chapter 16. And, you know, and some say you're the Christ, or some say you're John the Baptist and all this. And anyway, so Jesus said that the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. The gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. And then the other Bible verse the Lord gave me was from Revelation chapter 13. And it says the beast, which is the Antichrist, the first beast, he will be given authority from God. God's the only one given any authority in the Bible and in creation. Authority will be given to the beast to make war on the saints and overcome them. So the Lord gave me those two Bible verses together and told me this is why there's a pre-tribulation rapture, because the gates of hell shall not prevail against the true church, but the gates of hell shall prevail against the tribulation saints, because the church age will be over at that time. Now, tonight, the Lord had given me a dream yesterday, and I was going to make a video about it, which I will after I make this one. I'll make a video of the dream the Lord gave me about his return, second coming. And I was meditating or thinking of pondering on that tonight and praying and asking the Lord, well, you know, show me more about this. And the Lord spoke to me and said, but the dead, you know, because the other thing he told me was about his second coming. If he wants me to preach about his return. But then he said to me, but the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of you who are alive and remain shall be caught up with them to meet me in the air. Same text. But the Lord spoke to me again tonight, before his return, before the tribulation, before the day of the Lord. And the day of the Lord is not a day. In human days, it's a 1,000-year reign of Christ. The tribulation, the return of Jesus, the 1,000-year reign of Christ, that is the day of the Lord. Not a single day. For all those people who are taking half-baked ideas that they got off of YouTube, don't know what they're talking about, and running with it, you better learn the lesson that a little knowledge is dangerous. You better sit down, shut up, and listen up that you might receive from those who God called and appointed to teach these things. And there's lots of hard-headed rascals in this world. Lots of hard-headed rascals on YouTube. But I tell you right now that the Lord himself is coming for his bride. And we'll be out of here. Those of us who are alive and remain will be called up to meet the dead in Christ in the air, and we shall forever be with the Lord. When Jesus returns to earth, he's going to land on this earth, and every eye will see him. And they will mourn because of him. Because the judgment he's going to bring on those who are here on the earth. Matthew chapter 25, the goats and the lambs, the goats and the sheep. God bless you guys. I'll come back. I'm going to make a second video about the dream that the Lord gave me. So I'm starting to get into that message right now. God bless you guys. It's the second time the Lord has told me, personally told me, and spoke to me that the rapture is pre-tribulation. So God bless you guys. And even if he never told me, as I said, the Bible clearly lays out that there will be a pre-tribulation rapture. No doubt. Dozens of verses. Nothing to do with people's emotions and all these, you know, logical reasonings and all this. And people's ideas that the church needs to be purified and all that stuff. Oh, people died and fed to the lions before. Why won't they die now? People will die. Christians have been being persecuted for the last 2,000 years. There's more Christians dying in this year, in 2014, more Christians died than I think they said it's like in the first 1,000 years of the church or whatever. There are dozens and dozens or hundreds of Christians who are dying in countries like China, being killed, that's not reported, and in Saudi Arabia and all these countries. They're killing Christians, and ISIS is beheading Christians right now. More than those that were fed to the lions in the days of the Romans. You need to go research that out. Go look at the Voice of the Martyrs, and you'll find out. More Christians are dying, if I remember, I'm trying to think of the statistic. More Christians have been killed in the last 100 years than all the history of the church before combined. Something like that is the statistic. Brothers and sisters, there's a whole lot more people on earth. There's a whole lot more Christians. There was only thousands of Christians tens of thousands of Christians in the time of the Roman Empire back in those pre-Constantine days. And now there's, you know, over a billion Christians. So there's a whole lot more dying. It just doesn't seem that much because of the world population. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. The rapture is pre-tribulation.